what I'm saying is, this is the function. So here, say hi is a function definition, right? Hello? Everybody hearing?
Yeah, yes, yeah, right.
So say hi is the function definition. If you only call this, if we call like this, this is the function call. This is the function call, right? We call only name is the function handler. Handler. Okay, this is the function handler. Okay. Okay. Now the function which will take the first argument as the function or handler, that is the setTable. So that is the higher order function. Okay. Here, what is the higher order function? SetTable is the higher order function because it will take the other function as the argument. SetTable function will take the other function as the argument. Okay. Hello.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now here say hi is the callback function, a function which we can pass argument to the other function. Okay, people understand, right?
Yes.
Yes.
So higher order is a function which will take the other function as argument. Callback function is a function which we can pass arguments to the other function. So here setTable is the higher order function. Say hi is the callback function. Now, if people understand, I tell the function handler also. What is the function handler? If you call bone just name, that is a function handler. Okay? Okay? I will explain the null function. I will explain the code function, predefined function, enable function, immediate invoke function, callback function, higher order function. Okay? Now, the main important questions, what are the arrow functions? Okay, what are the arrow functions? Okay, the main important, the arrow functions are, they are introduced in the ES6. I already told you, what is the ES? ES is the ECMAScript. ECMAScript is different, JavaScript is different. ECMAScript is not a programming language. This is only providing the some list of the specifications how to write the JavaScript. So we have the different types of the JavaScript. ES5, okay. From ES6, they will introduce the arrow functions. Arrow functions, okay. The arrow functions I will explain clearly later. Before that, how can you write the arrow function? I will explain. Arrow function is nothing but the shorter way how to write the normal function. Okay. Shortest way to write the normal function. For example, hello? Hello?
Hello. Hello, sir. Hello, Prakash, sir.
Yeah, you people hearing me?
Yeah, now I'm hearing.
So now I will explain the arrow functions. What is the arrow functions? I will explain clearly. Okay. I explain the ECMAScript, right? You know, I explained the ECMAScript. So from the arrow functions are introduced in the ES6. They introduced in the ES6. What is the use of arrow functions? I will explain later. Okay. Now I will explain how to write the arrow function. Okay. What is the difference between the normal function and the arrow functions? The arrow functions are the shortest way to write the normal function. The shortest way to write the normal function. For example, I'm writing the norm function. So this is the normal sum function, right? This same function I want in the arrow function. To write the arrow function, first we define the function name like sum, right? Sum equal to this thing, this parenthesis, this is right. So here we need to pass the arguments. Later, you give the arrow. is the arrow. Later, instead of line point, same instead later into the expressway. Here we can write like this also. Return of like this also. But with the, here we did not have the multiple number of statements. Only one line of statements, expressway. Then we don't need the block. Okay, that's why we write like this. So instead of writing the function definition, function name, all those things, we are using the arrow function. We write like this. Okay, we give the one name equal to s comma 5 of parameters. Arrow function definition. Okay, so parameters, arrow, the function, the task. Okay, so both are same. Here sum 2, 3. This same. You can define a constant because you can not change the function definition, right? So both are given 5, right? Some is all declared. We all declared the organization with other name. We all declared that name, right? That's why it's telling that some is all declared. We are not printing here, just print here if you want. Five, right? So normal function and anomalous function both are same. Okay, but the writing style is different because here you write in the function and again multiple is taking the so much space, but you can write in a single line, right? Only function name equal to parenthesis and what are the tasks we are doing. Okay, for example, we have the so many statements, like for example, let x equal to x plus 1, x is equal to x plus y 5, y is equal to y plus 10. So here we have three tasks, right? Okay. So if you want to see this normal function into arrow function, if it is only one, if it is only one line, we can write in the same line. But here we have three statements, right? Then you can put like this. You can put the parenthesis, okay? Okay, you can put the parenthesis. In that parenthesis, you can write the steps. People understand now clearly what is the error function. This is the clear understanding. This is a normal function, this is the error function. Both are same. But the writing style is different. So here we write the arguments list, arrow, and the set of the statements and the block. Okay? Argument set, arrow, the set of the statements. So both are same. Okay? So what is the output of word functions? 15 20 7 plus 2 plus 5 7 plus 3 plus 15 right? 20, because 20 means x is called express y. So here 2 plus 5 7, right? So 7, y is 13, 13 plus 7, 20, right?
Yeah, right. Sir, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, tell me.
Like first declare a function, then a function name.
Yeah.
But arrow function is declare const, like a const, na?
Then,
yeah. It is not declare y function.
Yeah, that is what I'm saying. This is the shortest way to write a normal function. This is syntax, shortest way to write a normal function. Okay, both are the same. Okay, but the there is a one difference. for the noun function and the arrow function. I will explain later. There is a keyword like this.
Can you replace the const function? Then what happen?
Replace means? No, you are telling that?
Function. Right here, function.
Here.
Yeah, const here.
No, this is wrong. This is error.
Okay. Yeah, okay, sir.
So this is different. You see, the noun function write this. Arrow functions, you can write. So somebody will ask how to write the arrow functions. You can tell like the parenthesis, give the arguments here. Here we give the arguments. Okay. Arguments. And here, arrow in braces, we define the definition. So I mean statements. Okay, this is the shortest way. You give the arguments list here. Here you write the statements. It's complete in the arrow function. So arrow function also for example, we have the, okay, let's see. Okay. So you know this one, right? So what you are doing is you are calling the sum function after 1 second. So instead of the definition keeping everything, if you write this function as arrow function here, like Okay, got it. Okay. I will tell later. Okay. So we can write this function like this, right? So somebody asked question. How to write this function into arrow function? Then you tell like constant sum equal to like this arrow braces. So here x column y, here x plus y. Okay. So in the recent times in the React, in the Angular, all of them use the arrow functions only, arrow type functions. Okay, they directly call the arrow function. They directly pass the arrow functions. Instead of defining, they directly pass the arrow functions. Okay? You understand? Hello?
Yes.
So?
Yes.
So you understand the normal function, core function, enumerate function, indirect derivative function, callback, hierarchy, arrow functions, right? Now? I will tell the main concept closer. In every interview, almost 90% of the interview, they will ask, what is the closures? What are the closures in the JavaScript? The main question they are asking, what are the closures in the JavaScript? Okay, let me explain. Okay, for example, what is output?
10.
I think 2 times 10.
2 times 10? Let's see.
Yes. Yes.
Sorry, Panjul is error. No. you are wrong, because the scope of the variable in the function is only the function scope. For example, if you, when will your answer is correct? Now, what is the scope of the variable x? Global. It is outside the function. Okay, right?
5 by 10.
Now, what is the answer?
10 5.
Yes.
10 5 or 10 10?
10 10.
Because this the variable is a global level. The scope of the, this is called scope of the variable. Here the scope of the variable x is the global level. So it will call inside the function, inside the function the value is 10. Outside the variable, outside the also the value is 10. Right? This is the scope of the variable. Now here the scope of the variable x is the global. Okay. Now the scope of the variable, what is the, now what is the scope of the variable here?
Block.
Only the function.
Block scope.
The function scope. Okay. Only the function scope. So this is called scope of the variable. Okay. Now I'm going to explain the clear concept of the closures. Okay. Let's see. We can write a function into other function. That is called inner function. We can define a function into other function. Okay. Now, here dosum is the inner function of the sum function, right? Here dosum function is the inner function of the sum function. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes.
So here sum is the outer function, dosum is the inner function. So here what is the outer function? Here, what is the outer function?
Sum.
What is the inner function?
Do sum.
So, what is the variable of x here? Scope of the variable, here we have the x, right? What is the scope of the x here?
Function.
Total sum function. So, what is the scope of the variable y here?
Or do sum function.
Do sum function.
No.
Only?
Yes.
Yeah, only I will explain. Only this function scope only. This is called lexical scope. Someone asked, what is the lexical scope? The scope of the variable in a function is called the lexical scope. Lexical scope. Okay. Now, can I access the this y variable and also the, can I access the, so y is the inner function variable, right? Can I access the y variable in outside of the function? So that means, can I access the inner function variable into outer function variable? Can I access the inner function variable into outer function variable? Here, y is the inner function variable, inner function scope. So can I access this inner function in the outside scope? Let's see.
No.
No, right? So we cannot inner function variable into outer function scope, because the scope of the variable y is the only till here. Okay. So we cannot access the inner function variable scope into outer variable scope. Now the second thing. Can I access the x variable into inner function? That means, can I access the outer variable into inner function, outer scope variable, outer function into inner function? Let's see.
all do some function.
We are able to accessing.
Don't call do some function.
I am not just asking. So we cannot accessing the outer scope of the function variable into inner function. At the same time, we cannot access the inner function variables into outer function variable. But if we call the inner function here in the outer scope, if we call it the inner function here. Let's see. The access command. The access right here. It access in the. So this is called the closures. So that means we can access the outer scope function variables into inner functions when we call the inner functions into in the outer function. So this is more. If people understand, right? We are not calling the inner function. At that time, we cannot call the outer function variable scope, outer function variable x into inner function, right? So here, we have the variable x, variable x. At the time, here we are not calling the do some function, right? We are not calling. We just using the outer function variable into inner function. At the time, it does not call anything. Okay. Hello. Please mute.
Hello, Galaxy. Please mute yourself.
कितने हो गए? 280 नंबर की प्लानिंग तो ये है. ये डिलीवर कब होंगे? जब 200 नंबर
So we have the inner function, outer function. We cannot call the inner function variable into outer function, outer function variable into inner function. But we can able to access the outer function variable into inner function when we call the inner function into the outer function. At this time, we are calling the outer function variable. Sorry, spelling mistake. So then we are able to call it. So what are the closures? We can call the outer function variables into inner function when we call the inner while calling the inner function. That is called the closures. If people understand the closures?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everybody, because it's an important question. Everybody understand? What about this one? You want to share? Hello? And this you understand?
Yes.
Gauru?
Yes, sir.
Temrata?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Pankaj. So everybody first understand what is the closures. Okay? Now, see. We have like this. What is output here?
10 and 15.
Huh?
10 and 15.
For example, I am putting the Y here. The other way. Okay. Not right. So let's, for example, T. So what is the output here? What is the value at T here?
15, sir.
15?
15. 15.
Yeah. Only 10.
Only 10 or 5?
15, sir.
Okay. Let's see. 15. Okay. Now, no.
not a number. Nan. Not a number. N-A-N.
No, no. So what is the difference between the do sum and like this?
Function handler and
this is the function handler. Call. This is the function call, right? This is the function. Yes, this is yes, the sir. Function call.
Yes, sir.
If you give the whole name, this is the function handler. What is the difference between the function handler and function call?
We can call the handler inside the function.
Huh? Function call. Okay. Put like I kept like comment in this one. Okay, let me tell you. Okay. What is output here?
Hi.
Okay. Here XT of parenthesis. So here why have the execution of the function call. Okay. If you put it here, what is output?
Error.
What is the XT here?
Function handler.
Let's see. They have total function definition. Okay. If you want call the function, you can call like this. Now it will execute. People understand, right? So function yes. handler will have the function definition. If you put in a variable, if you want to call that one, you need to use the parenthesis. Okay? People understand? Difference between the function handler and function call? Okay? Hello?
Yes.
Okay. Now, go to here. Now tell me what is the output. Okay.
Not a number.
What is the sum function will return?
Do sum? Yes, sir.
Do sum what? Do sum means?
Function handler. Function handler.
It will return the function handler, not the function call, right?
Yes.
Then what is the value of T here?
Function definition of do sum.
This will return. Right? You point, got it?
Yes.
For example, now. What is the output?
Not a number.
Now it will execute in the, now we are calling the, this do sum. We are calling this. So here they are expecting the define. We are expecting the argument. So that's give the man. Not a number. No? No, what is the argument? What is the answer? Don't confuse. So, 20. Here T is the function definition, this one. If we give the arguments like this, this T of 10 will go to here. So do sum will go to 10 and take the this one. Now what is output?
20.
Huh?
20.
20. That's it. So this is called closure concept. This is called the closure concept. Why we are using the closures? Because for example, So somebody asked why are we using the false closures? For example, we have the person. I want this person name is more secure privacy. Okay. For example, here, if you want the person name Ross, you cannot directly call the person dot name, right? Because you cannot directly call the control dot of name, right? It must be, it will give the Ross value. No, right? It will not give the Ross. So to get name of the person, you must call the other function. You must call the right, then you will get the name, right? So privacy for data privacy concept, we cannot access directly some names, some variables in a function. If you want calling the variables into that function, you use the closures. Okay, using the closures, we can get the variables of that function. So for data privacy concept, we using the closures. Okay, I will explain the what are the closures. Closures are the inner functions which have the access to the outer functions variable when they are calling. Okay, we are using the closures. Closures are used for the data privacy concept. Okay, understand? Any doubts?
No.
Yes,
no. No.
Understood.
No. Must be understood the main concept. What is the difference between the function call and function handler? Okay. Function call way different. Function handler different. Okay. So today topics. I explained the normal function, core function, arrow, anonymous function. IFFE, call by function, hierarchy function, arrow function, closure function. So those are more mainly recent things they will learn. What is the difference between the anonymous function and arrow function? What is the difference between the arrow function, callback function? What is the IFFE? What are the closures? What are the hierarchy functions? These are the most important questions in the recent interviews. Okay. So these are the topics we covered today. Okay. Tomorrow, you people, you are the task. For every type of the, for every function type, give me one example to me. Write one example and send to me tomorrow. Okay? So today class is over. Any doubts till now? So these are topics we have covered. So everyone must write an example for each one. Okay, so pratidaniki oka example raasi na pampichandi. So sorry, for everyone write one example for every type of the function and send to my email id vijayaprakash.developer.com. if you want see the class again, I will upload the video to the afternoon. We again go through that video and understand the again type of the functions. Okay, you must give the example for every type and send to my email ID. Okay, this is one. Sorry, if people understand. Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
Again, I'm asking if anyone interested, give some fees at least 500 minimum. You can give, that is your wish. Thank you and bye. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.